Bernie Ledden on how a chance conversation led him from the Flying Burrito Brothers to the Eagles. I'm John Bowden from Rocky Street Music. Working with Graham Parsons and Chris Hillman of the Birds in the Flying Burrito Brothers was quite an experience for Bernie Ledden. This was before the Eagles. And let's remember, the Flying Burrito Brothers were one of the original bands that really influenced that country rock feel. But as you'll hear, he was not happy with that band. He was ready for a change, and it was all in one conversation he had with a lady that led him to the Eagles.
I just followed my nose. I mean, so then equally at the end of 2 years with the Burritos, I went to one of the folky guitar stores that also had a showroom in the back, McCabe's Guitar Shop in Santa Monica, and I went in there. There was, you know, they sold LP records, they sold instruments, they gave lessons, they offered lessons to people in different styles. They had a repair shop, and they put the concerts on in the back and had people like Bill Monroe or, you know, interesting people come. It was a good showroom, too. And so anyway, it was a nexus. That's the point. It was a nexus in the music business in Santa Monica at that time for people like me that had a bit of a folk, that had been connected to the folk era. And so I went in there when the Burritos were kind of falling apart. Graham Parsons had left or been fired. We had Chris came home with Rick Roberts one day, and then we made this kind of soft rock album, that third Burrito album, the first one with Rick Roberts. And I thought, well, that's good. Rick's a good singer. Those are good, you know, decent songs. But that's not why I came here. I came here to play with Sneaky Pete, Graham and Chris. And Sneaky Pete was gone. Graham was gone. And so I was looking for something to do, and I just told the girl behind the counter that I knew, you know, or she said, how's it going? And I said, oh, I think I'm thinking about leaving the Burritos. And she said, you should call Don and Glenn. They're putting together a band, I hear. And I was like, really? And so I called their manager, or I called a guy that, see, they'd been working with Linda Ronstadt. I'd worked with Ronstadt before. So anyway, I called John Boylan, who was Ronstadt's producer and manager at that point. I said, either Don and Glenn are putting together a group. Are you connected to that? And he goes, well, I'm not sure yet, but, you know, I'll pay for a rehearsal hall at Studio Instrument Rentals in a rehearsal room, and you guys see what it's like. And so we went down there and played. Meisner was already part of it, and I was the fourth one, and we played and went, okay, we're a band. And then Fry was already signed to Geffen, David Geffen for management, and he was about to get dropped. So Glenn was wanting to put something together, and he and Henley had agreed to work together. So anyway, after about a week, you know, we went, okay, we're a band. So we walked into Geffen's office and said, hey, we're a band. Here we are. Do you want us or not? And he goes, well, he came to one rehearsal, and he went, yeah, okay. So things just fell together. But the music business, meaning folk and folk rock and country rock, that kind of stuff, it was really a small town on the west side of L.A., pretty much. There was just a few places where people congregated, you know. There was the Troubadour Club, the Ashgrove Club, which had been a folk club also in Hollywood, West Hollywood. And then there was the McCabe's Guitar Shop. And then down in the South Bay, there was a couple of places, the Golden Bear and a couple others. And those were the four or five places to play in L.A. area. And then there were a few up in the San Francisco Bay Area. And then every college town had a club that was like that. And there was a little string of clubs on the East Coast in New York, Boston, Washington, D.C. And that was the folk circuit that people used to work acoustically. And so those are the places we all still hung out, you know. And so it was really like a small town of community of interest, if you will, you know. Mm-hmm. So even though there were millions and millions of people in L.A., we ignored all those people. We were just focused on people who had like interests, you know.
We'll have more of our conversation with Bernie Ledden coming up next week. Go to BernieLeddenOnline.com. Make sure you comment on our video, subscribe to our channel, and share our videos. I'm John Bowden from Rocky Street Music.